Hi, my name is Sasha Nosov. I'm a member of SQL Server Product Group, and my job is to focus on the innovation of the business model, specifically focusing on the business model and licensing of SQL Server through Azure Arc. In this video, I will show you how you can combine the pay-as-you-go billing for SQL Server enabled by Azure Arc and the unlimited virtualization benefit. Before I demo, I'd like to put it in the broader context and explain where this new capability fits in the spectrum of different licensing options available through Azure Arc. Let's first of all take a look at the traditional SQL Server licensing process. It typically starts from procurement, buying SQL Server licenses via an enterprise agreement with software assurance committing to at least 3 years of consumption. In parallel or following that, typically DBA deploys SQL Server based on the expected demand, often exceeding the procured licenses or under-consuming the procured license because the projections are never perfect. The challenge it brings about is the customers struggle to understand the actual consumption, how to manage compliance, and more importantly, how to avoid the expensive true-ups. That is where the consumption-based model enabled by Azure Arc comes in. So there are a few distinct benefits of that approach. Number one, because it is all managed through Azure, you can now align your licensing provisioning to your organizational structure. For example, if your procurement manages all SQL licensing needs for the entire business, you can license the whole business unit or whole tenant in Azure terms. That's one option. The other option, you can say, okay, if, for example, procurement has budgets, different budgets for different organizational units, you can leverage management groups or subscriptions on Azure as your scopes of licensing. Another option is if you want to just focus on a specific project and license it separately, maybe as a new development, then you can leverage resource groups. And you can go down to individual machines as well. That's number one. The second big benefit is you can now track license utilization and ensure compliance. Because it's all visible through Azure Portal, you can see the exact number of licenses being consumed. The other thing is, because of role-based access control that Azure supports, you can separate duties between the procurement person who is in charge of procuring the licenses and paying the costs and budgeting, etc., and the DBAs who are in charge of organizing the SQL deployments and worrying about the performance and how many cores each deployment needs, etc. The other thing is, because now you have the full visibility of the consumption, you can adjust the license counts as you need. You can scale it up, you can scale it down, and the billing will immediately reflect those changes. So you never have to worry about being in a deficit of licenses or under consuming them, and always stay compliant. And finally, it allows you to optimize costs. Because of the pay-as-you-go model, you can basically adjust your billing and costs as needed. But at the same time, if you already have the active licenses with active software assurance, you can certainly leverage those active licenses as well through Azure. Now, with the unlimited virtualization support now being released, you can optimize your costs even further, because now you can take advantage of this very powerful benefit, which has been available to the on-premises customers, but only now is becoming available on Azure. Finally, all these costs, because they go through Azure, will accrue to your Mac commitment. And you also can treat those as your OPEX costs. So those are very distinct benefits of the consumption-based model enabled by Azure Arc. Now, there are basically three distinct licensing options available for SQL Server enabled by Azure Arc. Option number one is designed for a scenario where you manage only virtual machines. You don't have access to your physical environment. For example, if you're getting the VMs from a hoster or third-party cloud, this is your option. You license individual virtual machines running SQL Server, and you license the vCPUs of those machines. The second option is when you do have access to your physical environment, but you want to avoid any overhead of virtualization because your SQL application, SQL workloads are so demanding and you would like to give them full access to all the resources of the machine. In this case, you license physical core of the machine and you can install one or multiple instances of SQL Server on the same machine if that makes sense or the machine capacity allows you to do that. And the third option is where you also have access to your physical environment. You manage the physical infrastructure. You take advantage of virtualization because you require isolation between different applications. At the same time, you really want to optimize cost and take advantage of the feature called unlimited virtualization, where you can license all physical cores of that host, which runs multiple VMs. And by licensing the physical cores of that host, you don't need to license individual VMs. This is the case where you can basically have a very predictable cost because you know the size of your physical machine. And at the same time, you can decide how many virtual machines you want to run on that same host. And this is the specific feature that is just being released. And this is what I'd like to show you in the next demo. So before I go into the demo, I'd like to describe the scenario. Imagine you are running a production environment on a single physical machine that has 32 cores, and you've created three virtual machines to host different SQL Server applications. And you figure out that if you license the individual virtual machines at the size of the vCores that you have, it will cost you more than if you were to license the physical cores of the host that you run these virtual machines on. And you want to use the unlimited virtualization benefit to do that. So the demo will show how you can accomplish this through Azure Arc using the new feature that we've been discussing. So to do that, I'm gonna go to my home screen and I'm gonna hit Azure Arc. As you can see now under data services, there is a new entry point called SQL Server licenses. This is how you will create a license that will represent your physical machine that you want to license using unlimited virtualization. And I'm gonna show you how you do that. So I'm gonna go to the server licenses. And now we don't have any license, so I'm gonna create one. And as you can see, there are two tiles. One represents the ability to license the physical core for software. And the next one will be a way to license extended security updates when it becomes available. It's not yet released. So we're gonna go and create the physical core license. So the first step you need to do is you obviously, as any Azure resource, you will have to select a subscription and a resource group that I will be using. And this is a resource group where I have my three virtual machines connected to Azure Arc registered. So they are showing as resources in this particular resource group. And I'm gonna name my license Demo License. This is just the name of the resource as it will be created on Azure. When I click Next, I will be presented with next set of options. First of all, the license category simply reflects the tile that I selected when I started the creation process. The second one is scope type. We support multiple scope. You can create license for the entire company, you can create a license for a specific subscription. In this case, because we are testing a small set of SQL servers, I'm going to create a license scope to a resource group where I have my three virtual machines onboarded. And the billing plan represents how I'm going to pay for it. In this particular case, I am about to convert from the enterprise agreement and software assurance that I used to have to Azure billing because I've concluded that I'm not going to renew my software assurance. I'm going to switch to the billing plan through Azure. I'm going to pick pay-as-you-go plan. That means my future costs of physical core licensing will go through Azure billing and will show up as part of my Azure invoice. Now, as I mentioned, the minimum is 16, but my machine is actually 32 cores. I'm going to change it to 32. And this means my license will license all physical cores of my physical server, and I'm going to go next. Here, this is the most important part of the creation process. I have two options. I can activate this license later, or I can activate it immediately. When I activate, the billing will start. So the moment I decide to create with activation, the billing will start. Best option in my mind is to activate later because it gives me an opportunity to validate everything, make sure that my setup is correct, all machines that need to be covered by the license are in fact configured correctly, and then when I'm confident that everything is ready, I can activate. So I'm going to choose activate later, and I'm going to go next. We're going to skip tags, those are optional. And this is a validation step. It basically checks the correctness of this resource configuration, and I'm ready to create. So I'm gonna hit create. It's gonna create a deployment. It's gonna create this resource called SQL Server License. And that resource, as I said, reflects the fact that I want to license 32 cores. So let's go to this resource. This is my resource. As you can see, it shows that it's a pay-go plan, has 32 physical cores, it's a category of core license, activated state is deactivated, which means I need to activate separately. Before we activate though, let's make sure that I have all my VMs in scope and they're all configured correctly. So these are all my VMs, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select the VMs and I'm gonna make sure that they have configured to use that license to apply to each of those VMs. What that means is the VMs themselves will not be billing through Azure, even though they're connected to Azure, but because they plan to use this physical core license and unlimited virtualization benefit, the VMs themselves and SQL servers on them will not be billed through Azure because of that. So I'm going to configure them to be using that license. And then when once I select it, I can hit apply license. And when I apply license, the individual VMs will be configured to use that license for their own operations. Now I'm going to confirm. And all these selected machines will now be using that single P-Core license that I've just created. As you can see, that column now shows that the license applies to all of them. Now that we've configured the virtual machines to be using that physical core license, we can go back and activate it. So I'm going to say I want to activate the license immediately, and then I can say apply. At this point, the license is billing. And you will see the invoice next month reflecting the cost of that license based on the number of hours that passed since the activation until the end of the month. Now, obviously, your billing admin would want to see the billing data related to this license creation. And I'm going to show you how your billing admin, if you have that role, can see that cost actually on daily basis. So for that, we need to go to Cost Management Plus Billing portal. And like I said, you can only do that if you have the role of a billing. On that portal, you can go to Cost Analysis. And in the cost analysis, to see the details of it, you can select under view, you can select invoice details. And let's select a period of time for the last 30 days. to show different details of your invoice. And as you can see, this will show a list of different meters of different resources that are being built through Azure, including the P-Core license that we just created. And it's gonna show up as Enterprise Edition Host Pay Go License. And you can put an additional filter. If you wanna just filter, for example, Arc-related meters, you can do that by adding a meter filter. For example, I can select just this particular meter, which is, like I said, this one. And then the view will just show your P-Core license cost. And of course, just like with any other billing information, you can download it as a spreadsheet and manage it separately, make it part of your financial projections and views, etc. This is the demo. So let me summarize what we have done. I explained the scenario that you have on premises. Then I showed you how you can create a P-Core license that allows you to enable unlimited virtualization for your specific physical server. Then I showed you how to set the size and then configure all the virtual machines to be covered by that P-Core license in the framework of that P-Core license and not be built independently through Azure. And finally, I showed you how to see the end result of it in the form of the actual invoice details related to the P-Core licenses. I wanna make sure that you understand that the P-Core license requires an Enterprise Edition, so it'll be charged at the Enterprise Edition level, and the invoice will reflect that as well. So the meter specifically says Enterprise Edition Host Pay Go as the name of the meter. The final slide of this video will have a number of links you can use to take the next steps. Specifically, it'll point you to the documentation of how to onboard your SQL Server instances to Azure Arc, as well as the detailed documentation of how to enable the unlimited virtualization benefit if you want to take advantage of it, and some other additional information you may find useful. Thank you very much for watching.